The thing is to go get into the word and then act based on the word. Some people believe, but they are not acting on what they believe. Some people don't really believe, but they are trying to act without believing. If faith is that corresponding action is dead, action without faith is double dead. Are you listening? It could kill. Those are the things that get into presumption, into foolishness. There's a fine line. See, there's wisdom. He said he saw pastor after pastor after pastor, and he said they will lose their churches. They'll quit the ministry just because they thought that was great faith. They thought we're believing God, but they get discouraged. Their people get discouraged. So there's a place of wisdom. When it comes to this issue about action that corresponds with faith, what I tell people is this: let that action come from your heart. You know, I've known of people, they came to the healing line, hands were laid on them for healing. They were on wheelchairs. People, in the name of his acting, let's act on the word. Get him up. They'll get him up, he'll fall. They'll get him up, he'll fall. And somebody will say, that guy, he didn't receive anything. Who said? Who said? I was, you know, what was the case like that? You know, they couldn't stand. She was leaving the church. As she was leaving the church, she was in the car. About maybe like 100 meters. Away or 200 meters away. Suddenly, she just felt the power of God surge through her and she was healed. Yeah, another man, you know, they tried to stand him up. He couldn't. And then he got home and it looked like, you know, people thought he didn't get anything. He just held fast his confession, continued to thank God. Suddenly, as he got home, it was in his closet. He said he felt a surge of power through him and he had an urge just to stand up. He stood up for a while. After standing up, he had never done that in his life. Wow. Then he sat again. Then after some time, he had the urge again. He stood and he started walking. And he was walking ever since. So what I'm saying is this. When it comes to this thing about corresponding action to faith, it's not a formula. There are some basic corresponding actions we have in the Bible. Like maintaining our confession. Like praising God for the answer. Like not worrying about it. Sometimes God will tell us specifically some extra things to do. Okay, ladies believing God for a spouse. A guy comes around her. She goes to sew wedding cloth. The guy finds out. He drops her like hot iron. Her so-called corresponding action was what ruined the relationship. Do you see that? So, it's not a formula. It must be something that comes out of your heart. There are about three areas where people miss it with this corresponding action business. Number one is this. People don't take the time to build the word into their hearts. You see, faith is acting on God's word. Like now, let's say you have symptoms of fever. Some people think if they have symptoms of fever, what they should do is to just be walking. You know, I'm not going to lie down. I'll just be moving around. If they are moving around, but there's no word they are putting inside them, it's not faith. It's just willpower. Are you listening? Yeah. The thing is to go get into the word and then act based on the word. Some people believe, but they are not acting on what they believe. Some people don't really believe, but they are trying to act without believing. If faith, that corresponding action is dead, action without faith is double dead. Are you listening? It could kill. Those are the things that get into presumption, into foolishness. There's a fine line. The action must be based on God's word. So build the persuasion of the word inside you first. Then act, let your action correspond to your believing. Let it come out of your heart based on the conviction you have. Don't do something foolish. You know, don't do something foolish. Shortly after my wife and I got married, a couple came to visit us. We were talking about birth control. We said, what were they using? They said they were believing God. I said, as in, what are you talking about exactly? He said they are believing God. That Mark 9:23 says, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believes. I said, ha. I said, let me also tell you, it is also written, be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he reap. You are kicking ball inside the net. You are saying it won't enter. Okay, God is seeing you in 7D. Let's watch. I give you 11 months. Depending on how skillful you are at kicking the ball, we'll see whether this is your faith will work. Well, about 10 months down the line, my boy showed up. It didn't work. Yeah. Somebody will say, but they were acting. No, they weren't acting. You don't have a basis for that. You don't have a basis. There's some things people don't have a basis for. So if you don't have a basis for it, and you're trying to act on God's word, it won't work. Then, the first thing is to build a persuasion of the word inside you. And then act. Some actions are basic. Confessing the word, praising God for the answer, not being worried about the situation, not planning for the contrary, not speaking negatively. You know, those are basic actions the word of God already tells us to do. Now, beyond some of those things, let God speak to your heart. Let God speak to your heart. There's no one size fits all. There's no book of corresponding actions. You know, like when you go to log table, log 1 is 0, log 2 is 0.3010, log 3 is 0.4991, log 4 is 0.6021, log 5 is 0.6995, log 6 is, I'm telling you correct values. I used to know the log table like that. At least from 1 to 10, I'll tell you to 4 decimal places. Yeah. So there's no book of corresponding action that you just go and check like log table. Just go and check what sign 45.6, what's tan this. There's no book. It's not a formula. That's why it's a spirit of faith. There's some basic things we all will do. But when it comes to certain specifics, let God speak to you. In your own heart, there is the one you should do. Some people, they should stay on their medication. That's where their faith is at. But they now see somebody who stopped their drugs and got healed. They now say, if you can do it, I can do it. But they haven't eaten the same thing he has eaten. You see, sometimes people act beyond their faith. Sometimes people also act beneath their faith. You know, somebody was telling me, I was talking to somebody, you know, and the person was talking about that Abraham, recent conversation, that look, Abraham did not do IVF. You know, I believe God. I'm in faith. I said, ha, if there was IVF, Abraham would have done it. Abraham slept with Hagar. If there was IVF, you think he wouldn't do it? He did it at 86. Do you get my point? Yeah, sometimes someone knows not to do that. You know, maybe based on how God leads them. Sometimes, you know, well, it won't hurt to do this. Do you get my point? So people have this impression, if I'm doing this, then I'm not in faith. If I'm using drugs, then I'm not in faith. If I'm going to see the doctor, then I'm not in faith. Who said? Sometimes you need to see the doctor to know exactly what your faith is up against. So it doesn't negate your faith. Okay. Some people say, I'm believing God, so I'm not going to use credit. Right? I'm not going to borrow. They say, the Bible says that owe no man nothing but to love one another. He that loveth another has fulfilled the law. One translation of that actually says, leave no debt outstanding but the mutual debt of love. You know, and then they say, the Bible says that thou shalt lend to many nations, thou shalt not borrow. Okay, if you see, that is not a commandment, it's a promise. What God is saying is this: you'll be so blessed, you won't need to borrow from somebody. You will have to lend to them. So it's not a commandment, it is not an instruction. If you are not yet there, you are just not yet there. You know, somebody says, it's a sin to borrow. Then Jesus sinned. Then redemption is a farce. Redemption is a fraud because he borrowed Peter's boat. Someone said, no, he paid. Well, he paid after use. So he used it on credit. If you want to say that was payment. Yeah. Elisha, 2 Kings 4, told that woman. And Elisha wasn't just acting out of his head. He was prompted by the Holy Ghost. He said, borrow vessels, not a few. He even told her to borrow a lot. Plenty borrowing. And then he said, take the little oil you have. Start pouring it in the vessels. As she started pouring it, if only she had borrowed more. As she started pouring it, the wine started, the oil started multiplying. It filled all the vessels. He now said, go and sell it. Pay off the debt. Do you get the point I'm making? So you see, okay. And people have done this. The church gets an offer. You know, or a ministry gets an offer. you can do something on credit. They charge you just 2%. They say, no, we're going to believe God. You don't believe God. It takes you 10 years to believe God for that money. By the time you get that money, that price has tripled. Why didn't you take it that time and then be believing God to pay it back? You know, there's wisdom. Now, some people don't know how to use credit. If you don't know how to use credit, don't use credit. If, you know, the Bible says that a wicked man before who are not pay back. You know, we have many wicked people in church these days. Yeah. As a rule, I tell people, I don't lend something to someone that I can't give them. And you know the reason? Because I don't want to just reflect that blood. Because they may not pay me back. It's just a fact. Yeah. And I have to forgive them. Because I'm a love being. So what am I going to do? If you know that you need that money, the person says, look, I will give you tomorrow. Something can happen. If they may not mean to be wicked. You know, yeah. But you just may be, something may happen to them. And you may not, the last thing on your mind may be to ask them for the money. You too, you will even have, you will know that it will be wickedness if you ask them for the money. But you might need it for something. So I'm just saying in some of these areas, be wise also. You know, be wise with your spending. Someone says, look, if you're really in faith, you will just go. Whatever it was, God will have protected you from it. You do disobedience. If God told you not to go and you went, and it will be mislead for the devil. You get my point? So faith acts on God's word, primarily the written word, and also whatever word the Spirit of God speaks to our spirits.